Would you like to know which has a bigger impact on your technology career, your certifications, or your skills? If so, this video is for you. So certifications can help you in your career. Skills will always help you in your career. But when it comes to certifications, how you use the certifications can either make a big impact, or honestly, no impact at all, or potentially even a negative impact if you've used your certifications incorrectly. And sadly, so many people use their certifications incorrectly. So here's what a certification can do for you. It can build your brand, which is a big win. It can also get you in a job interview, which is another big win. But a certification, when used improperly, can actually weaken your brand. So we want to build a strong and focused brand. And that really comes through strong and focused certifications. We don't want to build an all over the place brand, which looks unfocused, which is really related to certifications in multiple people's careers. Now we'll talk about these things much more. So getting that certification will often get you an interview. Win, win, win. We love this. But certifications will not get you hired. That's going to be dependent upon your actual skills. But getting an interview is a big part of the getting hired process. And if you use the right certifications and you focus your certification training, you'll get a percentage of those skills that you actually need for the job. So again, it's going to be a big win for certifications. So here's what I mean by focused certifications. If you look at a network engineer that has a CCNA, which is kind of intro to networking, they have a CCNP, which is sort of a medium grade networking, and the Cisco Certified Internet Expert, the CCIE, which is strong networking, this person has built their brand and it looks very focused by getting focused certification. And guess what? That CCIE is so challenging that the chances of someone actually knowing how to do the job as a network engineer after the CCIE is really strong. Now that's exactly what we like to see people do. Here's the sad reality, and we see it in the cloud computing space, and it damages the brand of cloud architects or solutions architects, but I see it all the time. Someone gets five different certifications, all very junior level and all in different people's careers. So if I have someone that's getting an AWS cloud practitioner, and then an AWS Solutions Architect Associate, and then an AWS SysOps Associate, which is related to maintenance, not anything related to an architect's design, present, and sell career. And then somebody gets a DevOps Associate related to DevOps, which is another career, which is different than solution architecture. And then they get a Developer Associate, which is related to software development. This is actually unfocused. And it's not going to give someone any of the skills to actually get any job. And here's the reason. Associate certifications are very basic. They're kind of like an intro to the technology. But sadly, employers want people that are actually competent and really know the technology. But if you think about it from the employer perspective, they really can't hire people that do the job. Even though they'd like to, they just can't. So focus your certifications. Now let's pretend you wanted to be a cloud security architect. Let's look at what a focus certification would do. If you got the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Professional, to kind of learn the cloud, and then you had the CISSP, which is a really strong security certification, and you did the CISM, another strong security certification, not only will you have a strong brand, but you'll probably obtain about 40 to 50% of the skills you need for that architect role. So you're going to get some competency, you're going to get some good skills, and you're going to get a brand that's going to get you an interview. Now it's your skills that are going to get you hired, so always keep that in mind. So skills. Skills are really great, but again, people make mistakes here. The skills for your job is what matters. For example, if I'm going to hire an airplane pilot, but their resume shows me that they're a flight attendant and they're an airplane mechanic and they have limited expertise as an airplane pilot, I'm not going to be impressed. Now, if I have an airplane pilot that was a fighter pilot for the Navy that's worked as a naval aviator that's now working on the commercial airlines and is an expert pilot, that's the person I'm gonna hire. So make sure you get the skills for your job. So we deal with a lot of cloud architects and we deal with a lot of cloud engineers, and I'll talk to you the difference about the skills. A cloud architect's skills is related to obtaining the customer requirements, learning the goals and vision for the business, learning how that organization operates, for example, its business processes and helping to reassist them. It's learning how that organization's technology is today and what it needs to be in the future to optimize the organization's people, processes, and business. Then it's documenting the solution, it's selling the solution, and it's creating a governance team. But there's no hands-on implementation for the architect. So those skills that I talked about are the right skills for the architect. By comparison, if I wanted a cloud engineer, I'm dealing with a deep techie and a systems builder. The cloud engineer needs to know how to configure pretty much anything on the cloud provider's management console, as well as their command line interface. They need to be familiar with infrastructure as code. The cloud engineer needs to be able to code in things like Python. A cloud engineer needs to know how to run Linux scripts and understand Windows PowerShell scripts. A cloud engineer needs to know systems administration. So as you can see, we have an architect that's got a unique set of skills and a cloud engineer that's got a unique set of skills. Now, if I'm hiring an architect, I need someone with architect skills. And if I'm hiring a cloud engineer, I need someone with cloud engineering skills. So please get the right skills for your career. It saddens me when I interview people and I've seen they've worked so hard and they've learned so much, but their skills for somebody else's job and I just can't hire them for the job they came for. They've got to go work in someone else's job. So please think of that. So it's not about your certifications or your skills. You should get both, but please make sure you focus most of your time at being great at your job and use certifications to boost your brand, help you get that interview, and get hired for your skills. So get strong skills. If you'd like to become a cloud architect, a solutions architect, an enterprise architect, or an AI architect, we have free webinars that will help you get your first architect job, and we'll cover all the skills you need. And the links for these free webinars are in the description of our videos. You can also find many free documents to assist you in your career, and they're also in the description of this video. And of course, we have programs to train you to be a cloud architect or a solutions architect or an enterprise architect or an artificial intelligence architect as well. If you like this video, please give it a like, and please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you build your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in a webinar or another video. Take care.